Hello.
Hello. This is Notte.
Yes.
I'm gonna go. Okay, you no fear no me one dabushing. One foot she won dabushing. One in the end yoshin she won dabushing. A jack of bojic or fee, nipple no fear no. One dabushing can help one yummy, one mammy, one sister. One no fear no, nipple over chill a cabotin when malami. What can one dabushing? Akashi e wala pe apone aye yesone no okana kewo won taboshi ke hanu fiano ke me awala ni eta ke ni bi fe no fi akashi da e ha bu mana gbinia wona e gbeshi ona atule ye ina bi o he won pia ke boche o fe o jenje o ba fata wo he ni ohani no fiano ni oba ye efemu kahani oshnako ni na watemo komokomoko ke ya somo chuemi ke ya somo na ba fe ke ya shipe ni wakele ba go in na be shina hi wake ba fata wo hi ni ohani no fiano ni oba fe ye eye emu ele obi obu ye obi Yesu Kristo ba
amen. No flower, no bow, no bow, mene woke bum black be me bi e na die no o fa ne ka ogo ogo din no ko hin be woke book lesson ko do won te mo no kai mo ka kama wa kai bu o obo mo de no ko hin be no ya blow ya trap no wa ya blow ya ni ka sa
fa ne ya ishi ba mi ni ni be ishi sa mi o bo mo de ni le
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. His faithfulness. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Amen. Now have the tune of the Lord is themselves comfortable. Good morning and welcome to St. Michael and Loyola, where we gather to pray at the funeral of Caroline, our beloved sister in this church, well known to very many of us. I'm only sorry that we can't have what may feel like a full funeral today. Be assured that all the prayers are included. Everything that the Church of England does for a funeral and burial will be done. I wish we could have more time for eulogy tributes and we'd actually be able to sing along to the music. But with the COVID situation, we have to keep this service brief and we have to refrain from doing things that may put more people at risk, like singing. That said, this and most other Church of England churches are committed to holding memorial services when it's possible. We hope that one day we'll be able to gather in the far larger numbers we would expect to celebrate the life of Caroline Badger Griffiths with more remembrances and more sharing of all the joy that she brought into our lives. In the meantime, you're very welcome here. You are very welcome to take photos or film if you wish. We have a videographer who is recording the service, and this at least can be made available to those who cannot travel here. If you need the loo during the service, please go through the doors with curtains to your right, my left, and filter down the corridor where there is one set of loos, which is marked ladies, but that's for everybody this morning. So let us gather our thoughts to pray together. We meet in the name of Jesus Christ, who died and was raised to the glory of God the Father. Grace and mercy be with you. We have come here today to remember before God our sister Caroline, to give thanks for her life, to commend her to God, our merciful Redeemer and Judge, to commit her body to be buried, and to comfort one another in our grief. God of all consolation, your Son Jesus Christ was moved to tears at the grave of Lazarus, his friend. Look with compassion on your children in their loss. Give to troubled hearts the light of hope, and strengthen in us the gift of faith. In Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. As children of a loving Heavenly Father, let us ask his forgiveness, for he is gentle and full of compassion. God of mercy, we acknowledge that we are all sinners. We turn from the wrong that we have thought and said and done, and are mindful of all that we have failed to do. For the sake of Jesus who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and help us to live each day in the light of Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. May God our Father forgive us our sins and bring us to the eternal joy of his kingdom, where dust and ashes have no dominion. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Merciful Father, hear our prayers and comfort us. Renew our trust in your Son, whom you raised from the dead. Strengthen our faith that all who have died in the love of Christ will share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Bible reading is taken from the Gospel according to St. John, chapter 14, beginning at the first verse. Jesus says, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. This is the gospel of the Lord. Now we have many fulsome tributes from people who knew Caroline very well. Most of them I'm afraid you'll have to read in your service book, but Mrs. Teresa Oblier-Ofe will come and give us a eulogy this morning.
The late Mrs. Caroline Adjikai Griffiths, near Baja.
Elaine, can we hear? Is it switched on? Yes.
The late Mrs. Caroline Adjikai Griffiths, named Baja, was born on the 24th of May 1943 at the city, Accra. Her parents were Mr. Daniel L. A. Baja and Madame Sakle Kufori, both of blessed memory. She was baptized at St. Barnabas African Church also, and confirmed at the Holy Trinity African Church in Iceland, Accra in 1960. Caroline was the 11th of 18 siblings. Caroline began education at Otomabihan Family Government School from 1949 to 1955 and continued at St. Barnabas School. After a standard 7 education from 1955 to 1959, Caroline helped her elder sister, a trainer at Mopla, for a short while and later went into hairdressing in the 1970s. In family life, Caroline got married to Mr. Robert Quinn, an army officer, in 1967 to 1979, and was blessed with 3 children, namely Udua, Emmanuel, and Joshua, deceased. Caroline later traveled to Nigeria where she started a little restaurant business from 81 to 84. She later continued her journey to the United Kingdom where she gained a job at Shears Coffee and Sandwich Shop, then with Powell Company at Park Royal Lisa, as she then worked with Creamy Fairas Cream Parlor in Harrow. In the early 90s, Caroline undergone health and social care training and finally gained employment with Notting Park Hospital as care assistant and worked with them till their retirement age. Caroline went to St. Griffiths, got married, and happily lived together till they diminished. Caroline had a calm disposition and was ever ready to share whatever she had. She was an anonymous giver, but quick-tempered. Caroline was a little nonsense, spoke her mind bluntly, and was very present. praise God. Caroline was a devout Christian and attended St. Michael and All Angels Church at Stonebridge, London, and St. Nicholas and High Church when in Ghana at Community 19, that should be any time she visited. Caroline came to eternal glory on the 18th of January 2021 at Moffat Park Hospital, London, after a great illness. She left behind adorable two children, siblings, uncles, aunties, nephews, and nieces, and a husband, and family members, friends, and anyone who had the opportunity to meet and interact with her during her lifetime here on earth. As humans, we recognize that death will terminate our lives here on earth, no matter how important that they are, even in God's service. In spite of that, and in the death of Caroline, the family has lost a priceless gem, creating a huge void that would prove very difficult to fill. A truly brilliant friend has been deemed forever, and memories are all we have now, and they will forever linger in our hearts and minds. As Christians, however, we have the confidence and hope that our beloved Caroline is in a better place with the Lord. Caroline, Yahweh, may your kind and gentle soul rest in perfect peace.
Thank you so much for that, Ms. Teresa. I will be referring to Mrs. Griffiths, Caroline, because that's how I knew her. And Jesus says, do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. And as it says in the older version of the Church of England burial service, in the midst of life, we are in death. Death may be expected or it may be sudden. Caroline's life was one of service, of energy, of giving herself for others. We, the others, subconsciously imagined this would go on forever because she was the strong one. And she took with her her beautiful smile, her lovely conversation, and all the other things we shall miss about her. But we're in the midst of a pandemic, and Caroline suffered a sudden illness and demise, as we know. What to make of the fact that we will see our loved ones no more, perhaps for a long time to come? What to do with our conflicting emotions, our confidence that they are now in the arms of Jesus, our sure and certain hope of the resurrection, but also the fact that, of course, we miss them terribly. We celebrate their life, but long for a few more days or years with them. But we do not fear, for God is with us. Do not be afraid, for he is our God who loves us, who strengthens us and helps us. He understands that our love for Caroline means that we must miss her, and things will not be as they were before. There is a great change in our lives. God, though, is waiting with love for us. He expects those of us to mourn to be comforted one day. And that is the job of the rest of us, to help those whose grief is understandably great to continue, and one day to forge a new life that will continue to be one of love for the person who has gone, and also love for God and love for those around him. Meanwhile, as well as our grief, we have a great hope. Jesus says, I will come again and receive you myself, that where I am, you may be also. He told his disciples and us, there are many mansions in his Father's house for those who believe and trust in God. We do not have to know the whole way. No one can get everything right. All we need to do is to trust in God and keep taking steps in his direction, no matter what. Then and always, God is waiting to help us. How Thomas asks, but Jesus says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And God says to us all, in no matter what time of grief and trouble, do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be afraid, for I am your God. I will strengthen you, I will help you. And when Jesus says to disciples on a hillside in Galilee, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted, he means too that we should comfort one another. Christians are to love one another and to work to the good of the world. Christian churches are to be open to everyone to come and encounter not just the story of Jesus, but the whole life of Jesus, all that he means to us, and crucially, all that he inspires us to go and do in our lives today. We should strengthen and help one another through this and all the difficult events of our lives. This then is part of knowing the way to Christ, part of the answer to Thomas's question about how we should find him again. And we have a God who may be trusted, a God to whom we can safely entrust those we see no more. Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles, and let us run with perseverance the race marked out for us. Amen. Mrs. Justina Everett, our pastoral minister, will read for us some prayers.
Let us pray. God of mercy, Lord of life, you have made us in your image to reflect your truth and light. We give you thanks for Caroline, for the grace and mercy she received from you, for all that was good in her, for the memories we treasure today. You promised eternal life to those who believe. Remember for good this your servant, Caroline, as we also remember her. Bring all who rest in Christ into fullness of your kingdom, where sins have been forgiven and death is no more. Your mighty power brings joy out of grief and life out of death. Look in mercy on her family and all who mourn her. Give them patient faith in times of darkness. Strengthen them with the knowledge of your love. You are tender towards your children, and your mercy is over all your works. Heal the memories of hurt and failure. Give us grace and wisdom to use aright the time that is left to us here on earth, to turn to Christ and follow in his steps in the way that leads to everlasting life. God of mercy, entrusting into your hands all that you have made and rejoicing in your communion with all your faithful people, we make our prayers through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Amen.
Let us pray with confidence as our Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you very much. And just before I continue with the service, where we will have the prayers of commendation for Caroline and a blessing for the congregation, I'll just let you know about what happens next. So we will be going on for burial to Willesden New Cemetery. Cemetery in Franklin Road. The Anglican burial service after a funeral in church is very, very short. And these days, we lower the coffin immediately at the beginning of the service. So the part that I have to say and pray with you will come first, and then at that point, the funeral directors and I will withdraw so that you don't have to worry about people who aren't in your household. And you'll then be able to get all the way around the grave and be able to have whichever remembrances and prayers that you would like as families after that point. And so now I will say the prayers of commendation and blessing, and then we will have some hymns played for us, to which we try to remember not to sing along, and then you can file out of the church at your leisure so you're not too crowded. Okay, so if we gather our thoughts to continue in prayer. Let us commend Caroline to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. God, our Creator and Redeemer, by your power Christ conquered death and entered into glory. Confident of his victory and claiming his promises, we entrust Caroline to your mercy. In the name of Jesus our Lord, who died and is alive and reigns with you, now and forever. Amen. May Christ, who brings out of grief, brings new hope and a new future, fill you with his new life and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen. And we will now hear the hymns, Abide with Me and Guide Me, O Thou Great Redeemer, before and during the recessional. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do?
cemetery. The cars are a bit ahead, there's a bit of traffic, so very soon we'll be behind the hearse. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to go off for a second. I'll come back very soon. So please come back, go back to use the link again within the next 5 minutes or so to get you back online again. Okay, I'm going off. I'm going to come back again. Thank you very much.